मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हियर आई एम योर जी के टीचर एंड आई वेलकम यू टू योर जी के क्लास. यस, सो लेट अस स्टार्ट अ चैप्टर वन. यस माई डियर स्टूडेंट, वॉट इज योर चैप्टर वन? योर चैप्टर वन इज ऑल अबाउट कंस्टलेशन. सो डू यू नो वॉट इज कंस्टलेशन? सो बिफोर गोइंग थ्रू द क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर सेशन, लेट मी से यू वॉट इज कंस्टलेशन. सो कंस्टलेशन इज अ नेम given to a group of stars in the sky that make up a certain design. Yes, and do you know that constellation is a Latin word that which meaning is set with stars? Yes, so people also used to give the name of constellation according to their design. Yes, so different designs are there. Actually, these designs are not always, what you can say, that real. Sometimes it is imaginary also. Okay, and people choose mythological names, especially mythological names for the constellation. Yes, so earlier when compass was not invented, people used to follow these constellations in order to navigate, especially while what, sailing in the oceans and all. Okay, so let us do our question answers. So here in the book, you can see your book. Here the question is given, look at the picture and name the constellation. Number one is given the plow. So the answer will be here, beak deeper. Yes, number two question is the great bear. And the answer will be Ursa Major. Yes, so the great bear, the picture of great bear, the constellation which look like great bear is known as Ursa Major constellation. Yes, number three, the constellation which look like the hunter is known as Orion. Yes, the number four, the constellation which look like the smaller bear is known as what? Ursa Minor. The number five, the dragon. Yes, the constellation which look like the dragon is known as what? Draco. The number six, the constellation which looks like the flying horse is known as Pegasus. Yes, the number seven, the constellation which seems like a dog, the picture of a dog is known as Canis Major. The number eight, the constellation which looks like the Greek hero, yes, is known as what? Hercules. So these are the answers of your chapter one. Number one is Big Dipper, number two is Ursa Major, number three is Orion, number four is Ursa Minor, number five Draco, number six Pegasus, number seven Canis Major, and number eight is your Hercules. Okay, so let us move to our chapter two. So what is your chapter 2 is all about? It is all about poles. So in SST might have gone through this pole. How many poles are there? North pole and south pole. So what is north pole? Let me say you, north pole is the northernmost point of the earth's axis. Yes, it is the northernmost point of the earth's axis. Its latitude is 90 degree north. And the North Pole sits in the middle of the Arctic Ocean on water that is almost always covered with ice. Yes, both the poles, not only North Pole, South Pole also, both the poles are covered with ice. Extreme temperature, you can feel extreme temperature at both the poles. Yes, then South Pole, what is South Pole? South Pole is the northern end of the Earth's axis, that is the northernmost point of the Earth's axis, a point in Antarctica. Yes, so that's why you can feel extreme cold over the poles. Yes, so let us discuss the question answer section. The question is, where state whether the following statements are true or false. So first question is, at the North Pole all magnitudes, at the North Pole all longitudes meet. So answer is what? True or false? Yes, the answer is true. Then number two, in the South pole, the sun rises every morning and sets every evening. Is it right or wrong? It is false. Yes. So, the sun in the South pole, the sun rises in September and sets in October. Then number three, what is the question? The magnetic North pole is different from the true North pole. It is true or false? Yes, the answer is true. Then come to number four. At the North Pole, the sun rises in March and sets in December. Yes, the sun at the North Pole, the sun rises in March, but sets in what? September, and 6 months. Yes, 6 months you can enjoy the what? Summer and 6 months winter. Yes, day and night. Yes. Then number five. There is no land at the North Pole. It is covered with thick ice, which may be 5 to 9 feet deep. One can walk on it. Yes, the answer is what? True. Then, you know that both the poles are North and South Pole. Both are covered with ice and extreme temperature, extreme coldness you can feel over there. Then number six, the South Pole is much cooler than the North Pole. Snow almost never melts in the Antarctic region. Yes, the answer is true. Yes, then number seven, there are huge reserves of oil deposits under the Arctic ice. Yes, it is true. Do you know how much oil is deposited there? Around 90 billion barrel oil is deposited under those Arctic ice. Yes, so it's an interesting fact. Yes, then number eight, many people live in the Antarctica or the South Pole. Is it true or false? It is completely false, because it is not possible to live at those poles, because extreme temperature, extreme coldness can feel over there. Only people go for researches and all other very, what you can say, that measure works. But many people don't live over there. Then come to number 9 question. Robert E. Peary was the first person to reach the North Pole on 6th April 1909. Is it true or wrong? Yes, the answer is correct. He was the first person to reach the North Pole on 6th of April 1909. So the answer is correct. So it is true. Then number 10. Antarctica makes up more than 3/4 of the world's global freshwater reserves. Yes. Yes, under the ice, in the form of ice, 3/4 of the world's global freshwater reserves over Antarctica. Yes, it's an interesting fact. You should remember all these things. It will definitely help you in what? Developing your general knowledge. Yes. So, it is all about your second chapter. Then come to your third chapter. Third chapter is geographical terms. So complete the crossword to find out more about geography. Yes. So let us test your general knowledge. How much you know about geography? Yes. So here the answer is number three. Huge grassland of South America. Yes. What it is known as? Number three. Yes, it is known as Pampas. Number three. Then number five, across, it is a body of water that is partly enclosed by land. So what is the answer? It is bay. Yes. Then number six, flat land with no great elevation. What will be the answer? It is low land. Then number seven, the place where the river enters the sea. What it is known as? It is known as mouth. Then down. Number one, a natural circular depression on the earth's surface containing water. What will be the answer? It is basin. Then number two, large grassland of Africa. What can be the answer? The answer is savanna. Then number four, narrow deep inlet from the ocean surrounded by high cliffs on three lands. What is the answer? It is frost. Then number eight, a place in the desert where water is found. What it is known as? That is oasis. So These are the answers of your chapter 3 geographical. The chapter name is geographical terms. So my dear student, this much for today's GK class. So again, we'll meet in the next class. Till then, goodbye. Take care. Thank you all.